video before, and it was kind of dark, and you couldn't see both hands. This is, I'm in open G right now, so I'm going to show some open G licks that I know. So we're in open G, I'm a little bit out of tune, but I'm popping a dick with it tonight. Okay, so we're at the third fret, and we can play these notes here. String and down to the first fret, third string, open. Okay, this is our G7. So we can use this in a lot of different ways. We can also go up here. We can do our this is the G7. We can also put our finger here. Okay. If we add a bass to it. We can do an alternating bass. Okay, that's lick one. For lick two, we just did this. Skip this one. Remember, this is where our shuffle is. I think I showed this in another video. And you can really, if you bend on that sixth string. Because we have part of the pentatonic scale here. So I use this note here, so. And then you can play here too. Way into a major. Fret right now. Fifth fret, sixth fret, fifth fret, third open, make it major. So from the second to the fourth, second, third, shuffle. Thank you. so those were one chord licks, your G chord. Now we'll go to the 4 chord, which is at the 5th fret. So from the 5th fret to the 7th, to the 8th, to the 7th, 7th, or 8th, or 8th, yeah.
Thank you.
this video, I'm going to go through some of these licks I just did, but with a flat pick. I don't use a flat pick, okay? I use finger picks and a thumb pick, and they're hard as hell to learn how to use. Years ago, I used to play with a flat pick, but I found that I can't really dig in with it. That's why I use finger picks and a thumb pick. A lot of people don't. So don't feel that, you know, you have to play this style of guitar. You can use a flat pick, but you're not ever going to get the amount of dig or power into it that you do with a thumb pick or finger picks. So we learned these things. Just like you would a C, okay, to do your four chord up here. One chord. Five chord. And for my five chord, what I'm doing is just doing this first, on the second string at the first fret. Second fret at the third string, and playing all these four open. Four chord. One chord. So you can play all over in this area. So there's a lot of stuff that you can play just in the one chord, all right? There's a whole bunch of old Delta one chord blues. The thumb pick and finger picks, and I can tell you it is very difficult to learn. Okay, it took me a long time to learn it. For some people it might not take as long, but I had a real son of a bitch of a time with it. But for me, like I said, digging in, being able to dig in, it just, the guitar sounds better to me. Listening to their records, you can pick their stuff up a lot easier. When you're hitting those basses, here's a Sunhouse lick. That's the seventh of the four chord. Here's your four chord, here's your seventh. Here's your one chord, here's your seventh. Here's your five chord, here's your seventh. Okay? So where was I? Thank you. those Robert Johnson legs. Sunhouse thing again, but I'm going to use a flat pick. It's very difficult for me to do, so bear with me. Try and get a handle on it. Just start out by going by doing your seventh chord, G7, and alternating and sliding. Doing the whole turnaround, I just just went. String and second string. Second and third string. And then you can go down on those strings to go into your four chord. One chord. And for that lick, all I did was go to the fifth string, which is your G. Fifth fret, and then hit that open G while I'm thumping on the low G, because this is tuned to G too. Then go to the five chord, four, one. A lot that you can do in this tuning, like if you like Delta Blues stuff, because there's so many different licks. I'm going back to the finger pick and thumb pick because that's how I play best, and that's what I like the best, and I can get a really dig in, like I said. So we know this lick. Thank you. these licks, mainly what I'm playing right now is like Sunhouse, Robert Johnson type of stuff. They recycled and used the same licks over and over again. Okay? So once you learn their main licks, you can sit and play for 8 hours straight in open G and not get bored. You might bore some of the people around you, but you won't get bored. Okay? And don't forget, you can do the alternating bass too. If you're new to slide, keep yourself contained to one tiny little area. I find even playing electric guitar too, if you keep yourself contained to a tiny little area, it makes it forces you to become more creative. Learn your intervals. Four chord. One chord. chord. Second to the seventh. So when I was doing my five chord to the fourth, so going.